Hello friends, myself I am Geeta Devi Bhaskar, Assistant Professor at Civil Engineering Department, G.H. Raisoni Academy of Engineering and Technology, Nagpur. Today I am here to deliver a lecture upon flow through open channel. Flow through open channel is a topic that belongs to fluid mechanics in the field of civil engineering. Fluid mechanics is a subject that deals with the various applications in the field of civil engineering. It has its application in chemical engineering, in mechanical engineering, in ocean engineering. Flow through open channels deals with the flow having the free surface at its top surface. Free surface is a surface that is subjected to atmospheric pressure. Flow through open channels is subjected to atmospheric pressure through a passage is known as flow through open channels. The liquid generally considered in open channels is nothing but a water. Water is the basic liquid that is used in open channels. Flow through open channels is similar to flow through pipes. Flow through pipes and open channels are two different things that are considered in the fluid mechanics. It is a very important topic as it deals with the fluid that is used in day to day life. For supply of water, we need either canals, channels, pipes, and there are various modes of transportation of water for various purposes such as cultivation, agriculture, and so on. Flow through open channels can be classified into various types. Supply can be through the rectangular channel, trapezoidal channel, either circular or triangular channels. In case of open channels, if the fluid is flowing through a open channel, it is subjected to atmospheric pressure, and the main source of flow is nothing but a gravitational force, that is a driving force that is used to flow that water through one place to other. In case of flow through open channels, hydraulic gradient line is always coincide with the free surface of water. What is free surface? That is generally used term. If the water is flowing through a channel, the free surface is nothing but the top surface that is susceptible or that is subjected to atmospheric pressure. If atmospheric pressure is coming in contact with this free surface, then that free surface is subjected to atmospheric pressure, and this type of channel is known as open channel. Similarly, if the flow is through the pipe and the pipe is in partially running condition, this surface which is subjected to atmospheric pressure, this atmospheric pressure and this type of a section is known as open channel. And if a pipe is fully filled, the fluid that is flowing through a pipe, if it is in full condition and the entire fluid is coming in contact with the entire periphery of the pipe, then that is a flow through pipes. There are difference between flow through pipes and flow through channels. First, if this is a flow through pipe which is running in a full condition subjected to water, and this is a channel that is subjected to atmospheric pressure, then this is pipe flow and this is open channel flow. Both are having its applications, as pipe flow is generally used for distribution of water to the generally for the society, for distribution of water in a network, pipe network we generally go for pipe flow, and open channel flow for irrigation purpose, for other purposes. In case of pipe flow, surface free is not subjected to atmospheric pressure. And in case of open channel flow, the surface is subjected to atmospheric pressure. Here, in case of pipe flow, the driving force is generally pressure, and in case of open channel flow, the driving force is due to gravity. Here the driving force is pressure. In case of pipe flow, the cross section is generally is of circular, but in case of open channel the cross section may vary. It can be rectangular, it can be circular, it can be triangular, it can be of trapezoidal section. Depends upon the shape, accordingly the discharge will be varying for both the type of sections. This was the difference in between pipe flow and open channel flow. Now let us see the classification of flow in open channels. Classification of flow in open channel. There are four types of classification of flow in open channel. First one is steady flow and unsteady flow. Second one is uniform flow and non-uniform flow. And the third one is laminar flow and turbulent flow. Fourth one is subcritical flow, critical flow and supercritical flow. First one is steady flow and unsteady flow. What is steady flow and unsteady flow? Let us see what is it. So, steady flow is a flow in which the fluid characteristics such as velocity, rate of flow, the depth of flow, if it is varying with time, then it is an unsteady flow. If it is not varying with time, it is steady flow. So, the change in velocity, that is del v upon del t, is constant. Del v upon del q upon del t is again constant, it is not changing with respect to time, and del y upon del t is again constant. If these values are remaining constant with respect to time, they are not changing with respect to time, then that is a case of steady flow. Now, what is unsteady flow? If these values, if they change with time, then that is nothing but unsteady flow, that is del v upon del t, if it is changing with time, del q upon del t is changing with time, and del y upon del t, if it is changing with time. If the flow characteristics at any point during the flow, if these values changes with time, then that is unsteady flow. And the above one, if it is not changing with time at any point during the flow condition, then that is nothing but a steady flow. Now let us see what is uniform flow and non-uniform flow. Uniform flow is a flow in a channel, in an open channel, for a length of flow, if the fluid characteristics such as velocity and depth, they are constant, then that is nothing but uniform flow. If the velocity with respect to space is constant, if the depth of flow with respect to space or length, if it is constant, then that is nothing but uniform flow. The same thing, if these values del v upon del s does not remain constant, the depth with respect to length does not remain constant, then that type of flow is nothing but a non-uniform flow, that is del v upon del s is not constant, del y upon del s is not constant, that is nothing but non-uniform flow. The third one is laminar and turbulent flow. What do you understand by laminar? Laminar flow is a flow in which if the fluid is flowing in a straight path, the fluid particles are moving in a straight path, then that is nothing but a laminar flow. Similarly, turbulent flow, if the turbulent flow in turbulent flow, the fluids will not flow in a straight path, they are going to flow in a zigzag manner. If this is a channel, or if the flow is taking place, if the fluid particles are moving in a straight line, their particles are parallel to each other, such type of flow is known as laminar flow. Turbulent flow, if the fluid particles are moving in a zigzag manner, they are crossing to each other, they are not moving in a straight line, they are not following a single path, then that type of flow is known as turbulent flow. So, basically laminar flow and turbulent flow depends upon the number that is known as Reynolds number. Reynolds number is nothing but a number which is calculated by formula rho v r by mu, where rho and mu, rho is density and mu is viscosity, v is velocity, so these are the terms, and r that is hydraulic radius. These are the terms that are considered to find out a Reynolds number, and on the basis of Reynolds number we are able to calculate or we are able to find out whether the flow is laminar or the flow is turbulent flow. In case of laminar flow, if the Reynolds number is less than 500, Reynolds number is in between or it is less 500 or 600, if the Reynolds number is 500 or 600, if it is in that range, then the flow is laminar flow. If the Reynolds number is more than 2000, then that type of flow is nothing but a turbulent flow. And if the Reynolds number is in between 500 to 2000, then the flow comes under transitional flow. So, basically laminar flow and turbulent flow, that depends upon the Reynolds number. On the basis of Reynolds number, we are going to get these values on which type of a flow it is, either laminar, turbulent or transitional. And the last one that we are going to see, that is critical, supercritical and subcritical. So, critical, supercritical and subcritical, that depends upon the Frost number. If the Frost number is equal to 1, then the flow is nothing but a critical flow. If the Frost number is more than 1, then the flow that is considered, that is supercritical flow. And if the Reynolds number is less than 1, it is known as subcritical flow. So, whether the flow is critical, subcritical and supercritical, it entirely depends upon the Frost number. On the basis of Frost number, we will come to know whether the flow is critical, subcritical or supercritical. So, if the Frost number, that is denoted by Fe, if it is equal to 1, then that is critical flow. If Frost number is more than 1, it is supercritical flow. and if the Frost number is less than 1, it is subcritical. So, these were the various types of flow that are considered in open channel. Now, we will go through the most economical sections that are considered in open channel. There are most economical sections that depends upon the construction cost of the channels. The minimum cost of construction, the most economical section it will be. If the cost of construction is reduced, the section will be the most economical channel section. The cost of construction reduced only due to the excavation and due to lining. So, these, if the cost is reduced, ultimately the economical section will be, the section will be more economical. This depends of, it depends upon the factor that is the wetted perimeter is minimum. If the wetted perimeter of an open channel is minimum, the cost of construction will get reduced, the discharge will be more, and on that basis only we will be able to find out the dimensions of an open channel and the other features of an open channel. Open channel is a most economical section is generally used to find out which type of a section we can generally make that channel in use. First one is rectangular channel. There are various shapes. First one is rectangular channel, second one is trapezoidal channel, circular channel, or we can go for triangular channel. So, these are the things, these are the various channels considered for an open channel flow. The most first, let us first one see the rectangular channel. In case of rectangular channel, if the perimeter is minimum, we will get maximum discharge. The same applies to all the shapes also. If the perimeter is minimum, the economical section will be most economical. It will be beneficial as it is going to save the cost of construction, and so on. There are four types of most economical channel sections according to their cross sections. First one is rectangular channel section. A rectangular channel section having dimensions B and having the depth D. This is the first economical section. The economical section will only, it will be on the basis of the minimum perimeter and maximum discharge. The area of this rectangular section will be B into D, where perimeter of this rectangular section will be B plus twice D, and hydraulic radius that is denoted by R, that will be the ratio of A by P, that is area upon perimeter is nothing but a hydraulic radius. For most economical section, there are conditions for a rectangular channel, that is B should be twice D and hydraulic radius will be D by 2. If these two conditions satisfies, these two condition if it gets satisfies, then the rectangular channel section will be the most economical section. Second, it is trapezoidal section. Having a depth D, again the base B, it is having a bed slope that is 1 by Z. If in case of trapezoidal section, again for most economical channel section, the ratio B is equal to, it should satisfy the condition, that is B plus twice Z into D by D, it is equal to D plus under root of Z square plus 1. If this condition gets satisfied and hydraulic radius again D by 2, if theta is equal to 60 degree. If these are the two conditions for most economical trapezoidal section. Similarly, third one is triangular channel section. The depth of flow, in case of triangular channel section, we are having a slope of 1 by z. Here, 1 is vertical and z is horizontal. If z is equal to 1, when theta is equal to 45 degree and hydraulic radius should be d 2 root 2. These are the two conditions for triangular section. These are for triangular and these two are for trapezoidal section and these two are for rectangular section. If these conditions get satisfied, then the section will be the most economical channel section. So, for most economical channel section, the perimeter should be minimum, discharge should be maximum. So, thank you friends. In next lecture, we will deal with the numericals related to most economical channel section.